have loved you so much.
Amen.
Not that I don't love the rest of your people, but I have loved you for what I have seen the Lord has done with you.
Amen.
And I would want to comment on my personal relationship with him first. And for this wonderful Spirit of God, which I felt here this morning. It was so wonderful to me. I don't know how you felt, but personally, I felt I worshiped God in the way that is recommended in the scriptures. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 4, verse 22, 23, says, "The hour cometh, and now is, that the true worshippers must worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him." And he continues further, he says, "For God is a spirit. Therefore, they that worship him must worship him." And sometimes the language of the Bible is very strict. And it says they must worship him in spirit and in truth. So, when the first song went this morning, and the second song went, I was lost in the spirit. And I felt that God was answering the prayer that I made. Back home, we have three services in a week. And one of those services takes place on Friday. And in the Friday service, we spend like 45 minutes, sometimes an hour, just praying. And in one of those prayers, as the meeting was coming, I was remembering that God should stand with us in this meeting. And God should be with us in this meeting. I was praying and asking God to come down in this meeting. Like the Bible says, Jesus said, "Ask, it shall be given to you. Knock, the door shall be opened for you. Seek, and you shall find." And I was asking God, what a wonderful service in Busiu. And I think God has done it for me as an individual. I don't know for you, but for me, God has done it. Praise our God.
Amen.
And I wanted to comment also on my brother here. When he came at our church during the August meeting, he left something that has remained still fresh in my mind when he stood up. The way he stirred the spirit, and the way he stirred the congregation, the spirit that came upon him, I had not expected it, that it would be in that way as a human being. But the way he moved, I tell you, it was a deposit that remained in the church.
Right. Amen.
So, thank you so much, Brother Nangosia.
Right.
And together with your sayings, there are some sayings here he keeps moving with. I see them in Mbale, I see them in Soroti, I see them in Palisa. You saints of God, really may God bless you.
Amen.
And especially for serving this man, I keep seeing him everywhere. We go to Entebbe, he is there.
Yes.
We go to Iganga, he is there.
Yes.
We go to Lira, he is there.
Yes.
Sometimes I call them people that run like yo-yo for us. Organizing, doing this. Pardon me, my brother. I am not ridiculing you, but I'm really honoring you for your service.
Amen.
Right. I'm really honoring you for the service. That is the work we are being called for.
Amen.
Even Jesus said, if any man should be great in the kingdom, let him be a servant. That one who serves is great in the kingdom. So when I'm talking the way I'm talking, Don't get the picture that you sense of seeing that your pastor is being lowered. No, he's a great man. He's really a great man, and appreciating. I am appreciating. You see, sometimes when somebody is not there, is when you hear a lot of talks. People begin to say he was like this, he was like this, he did this, he did this. The person is no longer there, and there is nothing now people are going to do for him. Even to hear, he's no longer there to hear. But now as I'm talking, someone can bless this man. That I heard that man of God commending him. I heard that man of God saying like this, this man must be allowed to travel. Let me give him money. Because when he travels, he does a job. He blesses the people. So let me put for him transport. Let me send him. And in another assembly, someone will open the door and say, let me receive him. Let him come. I will accommodate him. Because he will bless us. So, Brother Langosha and the wonderful care, the meal that we ate yesterday, was so wonderful. The meal that we have eaten today has been so nice, so wonderful. Me, for one, the place where I was kept has been so wonderful. I really appreciate the favor that God has granted to him. God works very differently, brethren. But we have to recognize the working of God. When we shall come at your place, we shall also notice something unique that God is doing. And we shall recognize that. But for this moment, I want us to recognize what is going on here, that God has granted favor to this brother here. If we need to hear that people that are not part of the church have opened their doors that bring visitors, we are going to keep them. That's favor. The Bible says he had favor with God and with men. That's the favor that God has granted to our brother with men, in the sight of men. And that is great for the advancement of the gospel, the work of God. And I think we should appreciate the Lord for that. Amen. We should thank God for that. Amen. And thank you for that good relationship. Amen. Because if you didn't have it with the people, there is no way they would open a door for you. No way. That good relationship, I think, should be kept. Yes. Who knows what God can do through that in the future. Amen. And for this wonderful work here, when Brother Nangosia said he has been here for 10 months. 10 months only, and he has organized this meeting. I think that speaks of the courage that Brother Mboga was telling us. The Bible says in the book of Joshua, be thou courageous. And I think this man has been courageous and strong. Seeing the way it is hard many times to organize a meeting.